Hi friends, Miguel from Figma here with another Figma tip. Today we're going to prototype thumbnails with overlays that have transitions in them using interactive components. So let's go. This demo has two main parts. We're going to create an interactive component where we have the thumbnail getting larger, getting smaller, and then closing after a delay. And then we're going to use that as an overlay that's added to a thumbnail. We're going to apply these to many different types of thumbnails to get the intended results of overlaying each of those thumbnails. Let's start on a fresh page. I'm going to press the R key to draw out a rectangle. I'm going to come over here to the right and type in 240 by 240 to make it a perfect thumbnail square. Let's press Command Shift K or Control Shift K if you're on Windows to grab an image from my computer. I'm going to place it onto that shape. There it is. Next, I'm going to hold down the Option key, Alt key if you're on Windows, and drag this over here to the right. This one on the left, we're going to create it as a thumbnail component. So click Create Component and rename that to Thumbnail. This one on the right, we're also going to make a component and we're going to rename that to Overlay. This one's going to be a little bit different because we're going to scale it to 400 by 400. So I'm going to hold down the Command and Option key. You can hold down Control and Alt on Windows to ignore constraints. And we're going to resize this out to be 400 wide and 400 tall. Let's make that 400 tall. There we go. Next, come up here and add a variant, and we are going to add one more variant to that set. So you should have three variants inside of that component set. This middle one here, I'm going to command click or control click on Windows to select the image in the middle. And we're going to hold down once again, Option and Shift or Alt and Shift on Windows to scale it to fit that width. Next, select the whole component set and press Shift A. When I press Shift A, it will make it into an auto layout object. Over here, I can increase the spacing. I'm going to set the spacing between those objects to be about 100. This gives us a little bit more space for when we are prototyping. Now that we have our thumbnail and now that we have our overlay, we can begin to prototype. Press Shift E. That'll take us into this prototyping bar over here. Begin by selecting this first variant and drag a noodle from the first to the second one. I'm going to set the interaction details to be mouse enter. I'm going to have it change to that second variant. Here, I'm going to set it from instant to smart animate, and I'm going to use a custom Bezier curve. I'm just going to type in the values. I know the values that I want. It's going to be 0.5, 0, 0.6, 1.5. And what that's going to look like is an ease in, ease out back. So this way it has just a tiny little bit of bounce to this. Now that this is set, let's take a look. Mouse enter, it's going to go to that second one. We have that animation. That looks good. Let's now do the second to the third variant. Let's drag another arrow. This one will be mouse leave. So this is when your mouse exits the overlay. And it's going to change to that third variant. We're going to smart animate. And this too is going to be a custom interaction. Let's just bring this down. It should look like a little bit of an S. And we're going to have that take place over 100 milliseconds. So that looks good. There's going to be one more interaction that we're going to apply here. Let's select that third variant. Come up here. Choose interactions, and this one is going to be an after delay. Basically, we're using this so then when the mouse leaves, it triggers another action that's going to give us the opportunity to close our overlay. So this is going to close out the overlay that's going to appear over the thumbnail. This is going to be after 1 millisecond. That is as short as you can go. Let's create a frame. I'm going to draw out this frame here. I'm going to take this thumbnail, grab an instance of it by holding down the Option key. So I'm making a duplicate instance of it. And then up here, I'm going to hold down the Option key. I'm going to drag an overlay. So the overlay is just going to be above the frame. And this thumbnail is going to be in the frame. I'm going to create an interaction between the thumbnail and the overlay, and we're going to have this also be mouse enter. So when you enter the thumbnail, it's going to place the overlay. We're going to choose open overlay, and we're going to set a manual position for our overlay. We want to set this to be completely centered over the thumbnail to give us the illusion that the thumbnail itself is scaling up, but it'll be over all of the other thumbnails. So mouse enter, open overlay, overlay, and we want this to happen instantaneously. Now that we have one of these thumbnails set, I can hold this and option drag and create two or three more. Let's keep going. Let's go all the way for four. So let's grab these two. I'm going to drag this for four. Now what I'm going to do is place in some additional images. I'm going to hit Command Shift K or Control Shift K if you're on Windows, and let's select this one. I'm going to hold down the Command key or Control key on Windows. Let's see, 1, 2, 3. We're going to open that up and just replace these thumbnails just like that. Now, if I want to copy that image onto our overlays, the overlays will preserve the override. I'm going to Command click right here and then hit Command Option C or Control Alt C. And then now I can Command click up here and Command Option V or Control Alt V. That will paste the style of that. So let's do that one more time. Command click, Command Option C. It copies those properties. Command Option V or Control Alt V. Same thing here. You can right click, copy properties, Command click right here, and then also choose paste properties. So this will transfer those all over. So you see all four of these have mouse enters. Bonus, we can select them, press Shift A, and we can center them in this space. Let's go back to the design panel. We're going to set them to the center and their constraints to be center. So now if we choose to tighten them up, they will tighten and expand from that center point. Everything is ready. Let's select our frame and hit prototype. Once those images load in, we can now see that we have our overlays. What's great about this is that even though they are inside an auto layout object, the overlay appears on top of it. And it always makes sure that that thumbnail has the highest Z index, making this great for using other types of components. Let me know if you have any questions. I know there is a lot of steps to that, but hopefully you found that helpful. And as always, happy designing.